Good morning, friends. I am your host, Matt Olin of Charlotte is Creative, and I'm so happy to see you all. Special shout out to those of you who are on the wait list, watching along live right now via YouTube live stream. Welcome, welcome. I'm glad you're here with us this morning. Okay, so why Zoomapalooza 2 Domestic Boogaloo? Well, A, it's the epic sequel to our first Zoomapalooza event last month. Two, we can still throw a funky fresh party even though we've been sheltering at home for the past 2 months. And no, Roman numeral three, something tells me you need a Boogaloo breakout to bust you out of your domestic prison. That's right, Governor Cooper's phase one of reopening the state begins at 5 o'clock today, allegedly. And so we are here to get you pumped up and primed and ready to get out there and take in all of the Charlotte creativity that's been eagerly awaiting your triumphant return to society. That starts today. All right, but first, a little bit of housekeeping. Now, for those of you who are new to Zoom or if you need a refresher from last month, let's just take a second to go over a few of the features that will allow you to engage with us and further enjoy the program. First, and most importantly, choose speaker view, not gallery view. You should see that option at the top right-hand corner of your Zoom screen. This is gonna allow you to see the person who is speaking or performing at that time. Secondly, everyone is muted by default to keep the audio as clear as possible. So do keep yourself muted during the program. That said, do feel free to turn your camera on by clicking start video. That should be down there on the lower left-hand corner of your Zoom screen because we want to see your beautiful faces. After all, the Charlotte chapter of Creative Mornings has been deemed the most attractive chapter in the world. And I know we have other chapters and the mothership tuning in this morning, but this is just a fact, okay? You got to look it up. Most attractive chapter in the world, and you would not want to keep our rods and cones from taking in all that gorgeousness. So definitely start your video. We want to see your beautiful faces. And you can interact with us and show your love for this morning's performers by and speakers by using the chat feature and the two reaction icons that are both found at the bottom of your screen. And if you hear something you really like, last month we did Raise the Roof, right? But this month, we're gonna stick with a 1980s theme. Harvey got us going. We're gonna start with a theme, start with the 1980s theme with the Arsenio Woof Woof, right? We're gonna do the Arsenio Woof Woof. So let's do that. If you hear something that you love this morning, we're gonna woof it up. All right, love it. Okay, so our May global theme is nature. It's a word chosen by our Salt Lake City chapter. The theme was illustrated by David Haben, and it's presented globally by WordPress.com. Thank you so much, WordPress, for your support. Many of you filled out our post-event survey last month. Thank you for that. You gave us some great feedback, and we've done our best to incorporate that into Zoomapalooza 2. So what you can expect this morning, well, you're going to hear some live music. You've already heard some from Harvey Cummings, and we have some more live music coming your way. We're going to play a game. We're going to give away some prizes. We're going to give away bolts of inspiration and hug grants. You're going to hear a couple of Who Built Me talks, and it's all going to lead up to a story from Demi Clark of She Built This City. And you'll have an opportunity to interact with each other as well. We'll be done by 10 o'clock, by which time you should find yourself falling more deeply in love with Charlotte, more inspired than ever about the creative work being done in our city. And probably chomping at the bit to kick off your phase one Boogaloo breakout in epic creative fashion. And hopefully some new thoughts about what nature can teach us regarding the strength and vulnerability and grace that we need during these challenging times. Okay, now with that, I'd like to ask my fellow co-host, Tim Miner, to step up to the Zoom mic. Tim, are you there, my friend?
Yes, I am, Matt. Good morning. Wow. Sorry. So I haven't had enough coffee yesterday. So yes, I am. I am here.
All right, here we go. I got my Creative Mornings mug. There, so do you.
Always be branding, Matt. Always be branding.
That's right. ABB. So, Tim, obviously we have some amazing, generous, steadfast sponsors who deserve some love. You're right. And you know that we like to show our love in song form. That's how we choose to express our love to our generous sponsors. So that, I think it might be time to sing our sponsor thank you song. Do you agree with this?
It is the chosen form of love that we give.
Love. Yeah. Love. Okay. Well, with that, I'm gonna go suit up and let's sing this thing.
All right, let's do it. I gotta make a quick change.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You bet on black. That's where rising star events can go. They'll be out of you offer. As if there was any doubt, Charlotte, you owe them a lot, cause they paying out. They're paying out. Oh, boy. Oh, oh.
Well, that happened.
We only lost 100 people off of the live stream. That's a new record.
Okay.
All right, you got to pull it together here, Matt. This is actually a live show where people expect to be entertained.
Okay. I'll pull it together. Okay. Fred Rogers is getting cricket on me here too. All right. We love our sponsors. And I want to further declare my COVID crush, my stay-at-home sentiments, it's finally phase one at 5 o'clock infatuation for our global sponsors, MailChimp, Basecamp, and WordPress.com. They support the Creative Mornings global community, 216 volunteer-run chapters around the world. And we could not do it without their incredible support. So thank you to our global sponsors as well. All right. Well, one of our favorite traditions each month is to have Charlotte musicians perform for us in the morning. Oh, bless them. Okay. So our special musical guest this morning is one of the few musicians to grace the Charlotte Star Room music stage twice. Von Hunter first performed for us on May 6, 2016, almost 4 years ago today. We were gathered at UNCC Center City campus. Our speaker on the theme of reality that morning was Dr. Susan Spatz, who sadly we lost last year. And Von was our musical guest that morning. Now, Von Hunter left home at age 17. He served in the US military. He worked in corporate America. And now he can be found all over the Charlotte area performing his original songs about consciousness and love and power. Some describe his music as a blend of driving rock reggae grooves with a splash of smooth funk, soul, and R&B. I just like to call it Friday. So friends, please use your eyes, your ears, your woof woof, and your tips to welcome to the Charlotte Star Room music stage, Von Hunter.
All right, can everybody hear me real good? Everybody can hear. All right. So thank you guys for having me. My name is Von Hunter, and I appreciate Matt and the Creative Morning staff for having me back again. It's always a pleasure to come and play some music and be in this environment. So my first song that I'm going to play is a love song. It's called Take My Hand.
Take my hand. We can walk away from here. Yeah. I took the journey to your smile. It attracted me right here. I wanna sail to the stars that's in your eyes. Love is blind now, help me find my way. Ooh, lady, yes. You don't have to go 10,000 miles. A step or two with you is all I need. Ooh, lady, yeah. So will you take my hand? Take my hand. We can get away from here. Yeah. So drop the baggage of your mind and cast away your fears. 'Cause I'd be willing to give all the things I own. Walk along with you on love's highway. Ooh, lady, yes. If you take a step with me, your time I will not waste, I will not waste. If you can understand my love and all I
you guys.
Well, guys, it looks like I'm up. I'm Tim Miner. I'm the co-host of Creative Morning Charlotte. So good to see all your beautiful, lovely faces today. It's the time of Creative Mornings where we give back to the community. We actually actively put money into the creative community of Charlotte, thanks to our incredible sponsors. And, you know, getting ready for this, I have to say, I really have grown to despise
the expression, probably despise is a hard word, but like I'm getting sick of the expression now more than ever. I'm getting all these messages that are like, now more than ever, it's time to do this. You know, and the thing about it is it's always been the time to support creativity. It's always been necessary and important to support with your love, with your attention, with your respect, and with your financial resources, audacious, unproven ideas. You know, Stacey Cassio, one of our speakers earlier this year, said creativity is not free. And she admonished each of us to invest in the creativity in this room financially. And when you do that, those things grow. And thanks to this community, that started 3 years ago with the development of the HUG grant program. HUG stands for Helpful Unfettered Gift. These are micro grants that we give out every month to creative projects across Charlotte, nonprofit, for-profit, people that have been working in the community for years, people that are just getting started. And, you know, in a weird financial economic time like this, you'd think maybe we didn't have the support. Maybe we'd have to stop that program. It's been amazing. Our sponsors, T. Reed & Company, Savvy & Company Real Estate, the Plain Language Group, Google Fiber, and so many individual donors have given us the funds so that today we're giving out 13 different HUG grants to projects across the city, visual arts projects, craft and fashion projects, music and performance, creative community engagement, media and podcasts. We did change it to $100 so that these people can get going right now, but these are real people doing the work in Charlotte right now. It's just absolutely amazing. We gave out 14 last month, and over the course of the HUG grant program, we have given out over 160 hugs. It's just incredible to see what it's doing. If you want to apply for one, if you want to give us anything, $5, $50, it will go right to the artists and the creatives doing this work. And you can do that at huggrant.com. And we will send out links to all those folks after the meeting today. So you can check up on them. You can donate to them. You can follow, you can buy their products. You can follow their events. It's just incredible to see what we can do together as a community when we give our love and our resources and our means. And there's two other things that I want to talk about the HUG grant program before we move on. One is that we also want to support our creative community with knowledge. So on Monday, May 11th at 7 o'clock, Rob Bacharach is going to do a Zoom seminar for anyone who wants to participate on the CARES Act. We all know that that's really important to small businesses, and creatives and artists are small businesses, just like restaurants and retail shops. But the CARES Act is difficult to understand, particularly if you've never gone through that. So Rob is going to do an hour-long Q&A and explain what's in the CARES Act, what it means to you, and how you can get started with it. And then a member of our own volunteer corps, Sarah Schwittick, I'm sure she's blushing because I mentioned her name. You might know her better as Shy Siren of Shy Siren Jewelry. She is selling a Queen City necklace right now on her website and Instagram page, and $15 of the sale of each of those necklaces goes into the HUG grant program directly to artists and creatives so they can move their ideas and their dreams and their projects forward. So thank you to this community for everything you've done to support HUGs. Please give and please apply for one. We're gonna give out another round in another couple of weeks. All right, now, we're moving at a breakneck pace, but there's so much about Charlotte creativity that we want to share with you today. And the next section is Bolts of Inspiration. This is an award that we give away every month to recognize Charlatans who are doing incredible, beautiful, creative work. And to do that, I want to ask Tori Savage of The Savage Way, who designed and built these beautiful awards, to come up and tell you who we're honoring today.
Hello, good morning, creative people. So yes, my name is Tori and I'm with The Savage Way, and my company's come together with Charlotte is Creative to, like Tim said, we just wanna honor some really cool creative human beings that are like making an impact in our community. So what we do is we make moss art. We make things out of moss. It's a preserved plant, and we do everything from logos to, words to shapes to full walls. But for this project, we have the Bolts of Inspiration, and this is moss art right here. So For this month, our recipient is Liz Clayson Kelly. She serves as the CEO of the Merged Men's Shelter of Charlotte and Urban Ministry Center. She's previously served as the executive director of the Men's Shelter of Charlotte, where she led the shelter's effort to renovate its North Tryon campus. So previously, as the associate director of the Urban Ministry Center, she oversaw the community's street outreach efforts and served as a project manager for the community efforts to end chronic homelessness. How amazing, okay? So she's also a graduate of Davidson College and received her Master's of Public Policy from Duke University. She is a proud member of a blended family with four kids ranging from 6 to 23. Liz, we are so honored to present this to you. Thank you for being an awesome member of our community. We really appreciate you, and we will get you this vote at a later date. Thank you.
Oh, that's awesome. Congrats, Liz. Thank you, Tori. Thank you. Congrats to all the HUG grant recipients as well. I got to shout out Von Hunter again. Von, you are incredible.
Thank you.
So please tip him, and you're going to have a chance to hear him one more time in a few minutes. So anyway, you're the best, man. Just beautiful, beautiful work.
Thank you. Thank you.
And look, if you love learning about what all these creatives are up to, I mean, the folks that you see here at Creative Mornings, the folks that we give HUG grants to, the folks that perform for us, you may enjoy The Biscuit. That's our newsletter, The Biscuit, at biscuitclt.com. That's where you're going to learn even more about the folks that you see each month, both on stage and in the audience at Creative Mornings events, and dive even deeper into the creative spirit of our city. So definitely check that out. And you know, we are committed to keeping you up to the minute on Charlotte's breaking news, or rather broken news, as you'll see here.
Good evening, Queen City. We interrupt your regularly scheduled programming, which if you haven't already figured out is pre-recorded and could be watched at any time really, to present you with this broken news story. I'm Matt Olin.
And I'm Tim Miner.
And this is the Biscuit News Crumbs. While announcing an extension of statewide stay-at-home orders to May 8th last week, North Carolina Governor Roy Cooper also shared plans to methodically reopen the Tar Heel State for business.
Based on available national and international data, and under the Council of State Health Officials, North Carolina's plans are founded on a three-phase approach designed to relax current restrictions, allow businesses to resume operations safely, and slowly reintroduce the population that has grown psychologically accustomed to life at home back into the wild. That said, this evening we have word from a mole buried deep in the governor's mansion that a second set of a three-phase approach has been secretly developed. The Biscuit News Crumbs is the only news outlet to have this information.
That's right, Tim. This newly adjusted phase one now focuses on the resumption of basic, hygienic, and socially conscious practices. Citizens are to wake up before 9:30 a.m., resume taking regular showers, brush hair, and you can consult your old photos if you need to, keep Netflix binge sessions to under 4 hours a day. And yes, I know the next episode always starts automatically, and that's how I ended up watching the entire Too Hot to Handle series yesterday instead of going grocery shopping.
Yeah, that's it. Phase two is now designed to optimize our mental preparedness. Keep to fewer than 5 dog walks a day, hire, by the way, a dog psychiatrist. Begin the process of re-forgetting your neighbor's names. Practice opening doors with your elbow. Wear pants at least 3 days a week, and send your kids to school.
Tim, Governor Cooper has canceled out-of-home public school for the remainder of the year.
I just thought.
Phase three is now all about enacting the skills you'll need moving forward. Phase out your crush on Dr. Anthony Fauci. Reestablish your traffic road rage. Post perfect Insta photos at every meal. Remember that staring people dead in the eyes like you do on Zoom is weird in real life. Extract the following phrases from your vocabulary: new normal, unprecedented times, and pivot. Oh, and stop washing hands. You know, Matt, that last one.
No, that won't be necessary.
Yeah, you know, you always should have been washing your. Matt, I
science.
All right. Well, that ends our broken news report on these unprecedented times. Now back to the new normal of your regularly scheduled programming. I'm Tim Miner.
Nice pivot. And I'm Matt Olin.
Yeah. You know, Matt, I am never shaking your hand again.
Stay healthy, stay creative, and stay the at home.
Now that's a segment that you could have watched last night at the new CLT After Dark weekly variety show that's being brought to you by our friends at Charlotte Center City Partners. So check out CLT After Dark if you haven't already. They've done two episodes so far and they keep on going. Friends, we started our new Who Built Me segment last month. Now, this is a moment for Charlottians who we admire to step up to the Creative Mornings mic and tell a story about someone who helped shape them into who they are today, to honor someone who had a profound impact on their life or their path. So today we're going to do that as well. And you know, the people they talk about could be anyone really. I mean, it could be a mentor, it could be a friend, it could be a stranger who changed their life with a small gesture, or someone who gave them a big chance early on. Our belief is that the more of these stories we hear, the more present that we'll become to the impact that each and every one of us can have on others through gestures large and small every day. And the truth is, these gifts that we give, they play a vital role in the economic opportunity and social mobility of our fellow citizens. And I think that's something that we can all get behind here in Charlotte. So this morning's Who Built Me speaker is Sarah D'Elia. Now, Sarah's voice is likely one that you're familiar with as the arts and crime reporter for our media sponsor, WFAE, that is 90.7 on your dial. Sarah fell in love with talking into microphones when she was at WXJM, her college radio station at James Madison University, the Fighting Duke Dogs. And since then, she has interned and worked at NPR in Washington, at WNYC, and in the deep south of Birmingham, Alabama. But now, she is one of us, a Charlottean, and she enjoys telling stories that are off the beaten path. Good morning, Sarah, and the Creative Mornings mic is all yours.
Let me unmute myself. Hello, that's a lot of myself to see this early in the morning. Thanks for having me. I really appreciate being here. I hope everyone's doing well in the land of quarantine. I've been keeping busy by doing a series for WFAE called Social Distancing, where I interview people from my kitchen table. So as nice as it is to maybe get a phone call from me for an interview, it's really nice to also talk and connect with people in this way. So I will jump right in because I am nothing if not punctual. So as the introduction said, I went to James Madison University in Harrisonburg, Virginia, in the Shenandoah Valley. It's still one of my favorite places today. And my college radio station, where I really started to kind of grow as a person in college, was literally connected by a hallway to WMRA, which is the NPR station in Harrisonburg, Virginia, like literally a hallway. So if you've ever been to WFAE or Spirit Square in Uptown, if you imagine a hallway, then connecting the station or the studio to a college radio station, and all the fun things that could come with that. I couldn't imagine WFAE being connected to a college radio station today. It was so kind of them to share their resources and also share part of their building, although the connecting hallway was locked at night, so we couldn't wander down there. But I really fell in love with radio in college. It's where I met all my friends, and I just got to go down the hall from WXJM to WMRA and watch Morning Edition, watch All Things Considered, and just see live radio being made. And it was just, it was like, sounds really cheesy, but it was super magical to me. And I knew that I wanted to do something in this medium, but I didn't really know how to do that. I had an indie college radio show. I produced and hosted a talk show. I became the program director of my college radio station. And I just wanted to do more and more. But I wasn't really sure how to do that. So I had a friend that was in a similar boat as me, and she suggested that I go talk to Martha. And Martha ended up being Martha Woodruff, who is now semi-retired, but she was a reporter for WMRA. She freelanced for the Washington Post, for NPR, and she's now an author. And the idea at one point in my life of going up and asking somebody for anything was truly terrifying. I still sometimes get butterflies before I start talking to strangers, although that's gotten a lot better. And she sat me down in her office and was just sort of like, what do you want to know? What do you want to know about radio? And it was sort of like, well, where do I start? And so I asked her a lot of questions. And I remember the best part about Martha's office was that she was surrounded by greenery, and she had lots of pictures of her cats, which I thought was really cool. And she had a couch in her office, which as a college student, I just thought was really, really awesome. So I would plop into her office on her couch like once a week, and I would talk radio with her. And she had just faith in me in a time in my life when I didn't have any faith in myself, and she really didn't have any reason to believe in me. She didn't know me all that well, but we got to know each other the years that I was in college. And I can't say for certain if I would be in public radio if not for Martha, but I do know that she was the reason that I got my first public radio job. I put her down as a reference, and she told the general manager who called her to see who I was that he would be an idiot if he didn't hire me. And she said that apparently laughing. So apparently Martha's belief in me was contagious, and I got the job. And he later told me that story, and I was sort of mortified and also like, that is awesome. And only someone like Martha could say that. She taught me how to be a curious person. She taught me how to ask hard questions and to connect with people and truly be present with them, which is something that's an interesting challenge in this age of social distancing. She actually officiated my wedding. And then several years later, when I got divorced, she held my hand the entire way through that. And I've never walked away from a conversation with Martha where I didn't feel better about the work we do, the world we live in, or me as a person. And I think that's really an amazing thing. So I guess to conclude this, I would just say that Martha taught me not only to be the reporter that I am, to be the curious person that I am, but to also be kind and to have, if not a physical, a metaphorical couch that a young person can plop in and kind of spill their guts to, and always be open and always be looking for those people that need the help and are afraid to ask for it.
Wow. Thank you so much, Sarah, for sharing that Who Built Me story. That is exactly why we built this segment into this event. So we want to hear those stories. I personally find it so inspiring to hear stories like that. It reminds me of how positively we can impact the lives of those around us and those who cross our paths. As you said, it really is about kindness, and it's about sharing our social capital. These are incredibly relevant ideas for our city in particular. And I also love what you said about having the courage to ask for what you wanted or what you needed. That's something that we talk about internally a lot. My wife, Sarah, talks about this a lot in her work as a coach, this idea of learning new muscle memory, learning how to ask for what you want or what you need. So we actually all have a role in the exchange of social capital, both in the giving of it and in the requesting of it. So thank you again, Sarah. That was really awesome of you to join us this morning. And to thank you, we want to present you with a camp at home care package from our friends at Camp North End. It'll be delivered to your door, and in it, you're going to find some instant Hex coffee that should keep you nice and, alert while you're on the airwaves. It'll have a Huga co-working easy mug, a Camp Fam thinking cap from McFly Fresh Printing Company. We love those guys. A Sprint book from our friends at Wiley, and some custom stamped pencils and a greeting card from Good Postage. Camp North End was selling these care packages recently, and they donated all the proceeds to the Hug Microgrant program. So amazing for that. I mean, that they funded eight hug grants. So we're super grateful to them, Damon, Varian, everyone at Camp North End. Please accept our thanks for that. Every penny of which goes into the hands of creatives all over Charlotte. So thank you, Camp North End, and thank you again, Sarah. Folks, I don't know about you, but I want to hear more live music, and specifically, I want to hear more Von Hunter. So let's hand the Zoom mic back over to Von Hunter. Welcome back to the Charlotte Star Room music stage, my friend.
All right, thank y'all. Thank y'all so much. Hey, man, that was a very inspiring story. I always like hearing stories like that, too, of people who help you along your path and, like, give you, like, so much, like, valuable input to help you get kickstarted in the right direction. So I really appreciated hearing that also about mentorship. You know what I'm saying? So this next song is, it's an inspirational song, I guess. And it's about being your best self. And it's called Whoa.
Best, and when they feel it, they'll say, "Whoa,
man, I do not know how you get up and sing like that in the morning.
Oh,
that is incredible, Vaughn.
Matt, he's got the old school shirt too, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got the old school Creative Morning shirt.
Yep. I love this shirt.
Folks, I think you'll agree with me. That was an extremely tippable performance. So please remember to tip Vaughn. You'll find his Venmo handle both in the name that he's put at the bottom of his screen, but also we dropped it in the chat. So tip him on Venmo to thank him for his performance this morning. Tip Harvey Cummings while you're at it. And you can follow Vaughn on Instagram as well at Vaughn Hunter Music. So friends, wait, what are you looking at? I feel like this guy's got it in for me here. Friends, if you've been to Creative Morning Charlotte before, then you know that we love to play games and we love to give away prizes. And so if you've been to Creative Morning Charlotte before, then you also know that it must now be time to win. So we're going to throw this little graphic up and you're going to see why we've been sort of bathing in the nostalgia of retro vintage video games all morning. And that's because our new friends at Skookum, and we love these guys, we're going to call them our tech Sherpas. But if you look at their logo, to us, I don't know if this is intentional or not, but to us, it reminds us of the Atari logo, right? And Tim and I, we're of a certain age. We grew up on Atari 2600. So we're celebrating Skookum this morning, but also just our love for Atari 2600 games with our Time to Win Queen City Quiz Show segment right now.
Quiz show at Creative Morning Charlotte. And before we dive into the game, we have two amazing contestants. I'm gonna have them introduce themselves. So let's first go to Antonio. Antonio, tell the audience who you are and what you do.
Yes, I'm Antonio Livingston. I'm a graphic designer and all around creative extraordinaire.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are, my friend. All right, let's go over to Dan. Dan, same questions to you.
Yeah, founder of Packer Place, run QC FinTech, the accelerator, and do a whole bunch of community building, bringing people together.
Well, we love both of you and we love everything you're doing in Charlotte and how creative you are. And so it's awesome to have you guys playing this round of Queen City Quiz Show. Now for today, we've been inspired by our new tech sponsors, Skookum. Their logo reminds us so much of one of our favorite things growing up, the Atari 2600. Their logo reminds us so much of Atari that we thought, you know what, let's do a game in celebration of them. We are going to go back and forth. I'm going to present you with a Charlotte edition of a classic Atari 2600 video game. And you just basically have to tell us which video game you think this Charlotte edition is based on. So I'm going to share my screen. Hopefully this will make total sense as soon as I pull this up. So here we go. All right, here we go. Is it full screen? I want to make sure it says it's full screen for you.
You're good.
Okay, so the Queen City Quiz Show 8-bit edition, these are Charlotte editions of Atari 2600 classic games. We'll start with Antonio, you get the first question. Here we go. All right, so you're gonna be jumping over, this is how you play this game. You're gonna be jumping over moving scooters, balancing on the heads of apartment landlords, opening their mouths, and swinging over gaping pits of extra sour craft beer. Is this Jungle Hunt, Breakout, or Pitfall?
Pitfall. Let's see.
Yes, that is the Charlotte edition of Pitfall. That's exactly right. Good job. You're on the board, Antonio. Dan, you know how this game is played now, so here we go.
All right.
Question two. This is how you play this game. You're going to dig for leftover gold underneath Uptown Charlotte. And when banker bros come after you, you're going to inflate them using your ego pump until they pop, or you're going to crush them underneath large rocks. Is that Dig Dug, Gopher, or Kaboom?
I'm gonna have to go with Dig Dug.
Yes, it is the Charlotte edition of Dig Dug. That's exactly right. It is 1-1. Okay, we're off to a great start. Antonio, back to you. Here's how you play. You're gonna find the key to the city and you're gonna use it to open the new MLS stadium. You're also going to use the paintbrush of rebellion to slay beige apartment building dragons and cover them with colorful murals. Is this E.T., Joust, or Adventure?
I'm going to go with B, Joust.
The answer is actually Adventure. This is the Charlotte edition of Adventure. So we have Dan as a season opportunity to pull ahead here. All right, here we go. Dan, this one's for you. The walls are closing in. As stay at home continues day after day, your roommates are drawing nearer and nearer. They're encroaching on your personal areas. You have to avoid them. You have to head them off at the pass or be crushed. Is this Defender, Space Invaders, or Berserk?
I have to go with Space Invaders on that one.
Space Invaders, Charlotte edition. Dan pulls ahead. We have two more questions. Antonio, back to you. Here we go. Question five. This is how you play it. You're going to fight off cankerworms as they dangle out of the trees and make their way down the screen. You're also going to eliminate the stink bugs that are coming at you, too. Is it Centipede, Donkey Kong, or Asteroids?
I'm going to go with A, Centipede.
Yes, of course. That is the Charlotte version of Centipede. And finally, here we go. Dan, this one's for you. Here's how you play. You're going to avoid touching walkers, runners, bikers, and strollers as you try to cross a crowded greenway during your escapist walks. Is this Yar's Revenge, Frogger, or Q-Bert?
I'm going to have to go with Frogger on that one.
We have our winner, Dan. That is the, not only is it the Charlotte edition of Frogger, it is the Charlotte social distancing edition of Frogger. So, folks, that is game over. I gotta say, you guys were perfect folks to play this game with us, which means you both are going to win a gift basket from our friends at Pure Intentions Coffee. That is coming your way soon. So thank you so much for playing with us, and back to the show.
We love playing that game with them, and we love our friends at Pure Intentions Coffee. And so to thank Dan and Antonio for playing with us, Pure Intentions Coffee is giving them gift baskets. So keep an eye out for that, Dan and Antonio. Those are coming your way from our friends at Pure Intentions Coffee. And by the way, have you ever wanted to learn more about coffee, or even the right way to brew coffee, steam milk, make a latte, make an espresso? I know my wife Sarah would love it if I did. So we are in luck, because Pure Intentions is offering free online classes these days. Just go to their website, pureintentionscoffee.com, and click on the button that says Skills Campus Online. All right, we're gonna do one more Who Built Me talk before we go to the main event, our speaker, Demi Clark. And our next Who Built Me speaker is Henry Rock. He's actually listed in the participant list this morning as City Startup Labs, because that's his baby. But Henry is going to speak to us here in just a moment. He is an all-around awesome guy, and he's a good friend. And like I said, he's the founder and executive director of City Startup Labs, which is a nonprofit dedicated to stimulating and supporting entrepreneurial activity and innovation among underrepresented populations of African-American millennials, as well as the formerly incarcerated or returning citizens. So Henry, here to share a few words about someone who helped build you. Welcome to Zoomapalooza 2. The floor is yours.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you very much. And good morning, everyone. Rather than really talk about an individual, I'd rather talk about those folks that shaped me. And there've been a number of them. They're shoulders that I stand on. And I'll start with my maternal great-grandmother, who was in the first graduating class of Spelman College. And she was a Black or Negro historian and also a suffragette. She established the attitude that we ought to be about uplifting the race. And so we spent a fair amount of our time, you know, sort of thinking about that as family. My father and his brothers were all aviators and engineers, and they fired up my imagination and curiosity and had me thinking about what it must be like to really imagine myself, much like they imagined themselves when they were living in Sheepshead Bay and going to Floyd Bennett Field and watching some of the early aviators during the late 20s and 30s, and seeing themselves also as pilots. They used to drive sports cars and fly planes and tinker and make things, and and that, you know, really also shaped me as well. I grew up in the civil rights era and came of age in the Black Power era, and both of those eras shaped me into doing the kind of work that I'm up to, as a matter of fact. You know, when I think about the work of not just Dr. King, but a lot of unsung heroes, people that we don't really hear that much about, those are folks that also helped shape me. And more specifically in the Black Power era, there were folks that I came in direct contact with, people that you may never have heard of, but Amir Baraka and Ron Karenga and Mfandishi Masai and Belosi Zaid Muhammad. These were people that really helped to shape me as a young man in terms of understanding further the contributions that I can make to my community. I'll also go on to say that I was shaped in large part by a lot of the Black media entrepreneurs that I had an opportunity to work with. The likes of Ben Wright from Black Media Incorporated and John Johnson of Ebony and Jet fame. We have Sid Small and Gene Jackson. And also another sort of unsung hero who was very very much a mentor to me. And that was, pardon me, Reagan Henry, who owned dozens of radio stations and owned the first was the first Black owner of a CBS affiliate. This was during the era of the golden era of Black media. And these entrepreneurs really had an opportunity to hire a lot of folks like myself who otherwise would not have been hired and get a chance to work in the industry that they loved. So these were, all of these folks were shapers of who I am. And, you know, I was destined really to do the work that I'm doing in part because of them. So I want to thank you guys for listening to this story about, you know, who was instrumental and influential in shaping the life that I've come to live for these several decades. And have a great morning. Thank you, Creative Mornings. Love you.
Well, guys. Thank you so much, Henry. That's incredible. And we are going to be sending you as well a Camp at Home care package from our friends at Camp North End in gratitude both for your story and for the vital work you're doing in our community. All right, Tim. Fueled by Henry's talk, we're going over to you now to bring us into the main event.
All right, I'm really excited about introducing you guys to Demi Clark. I carefully chose Rampage as my background because Demi Clark, if she built this city, is here to tear down misconceptions and rebuild Charlotte in an image that's equitable for everyone. You know, one of the things that's been tough about stay at home is that we're not meeting new people. You know, I think it's easy to forget that in our daily lives, we have this influx of new personalities and new people that we're meeting all the time. And so Matt and I made kind of like a pact, and we challenged other people around us to intentionally meet new people while you're at home. And one of those for me was Demi Clark. You know, got to know her a little bit during the C20. And then we were not friends. We did not even know each other when Stay at Home started. And she's the kind of person that when you crack the door open a little, she will kick it in and you can't help but just listen and be drawn in and then want to share her with everybody. She describes herself as a spitfire. And I think that is a very apt description. I also know that she hates the word pivot more than I do. And I'm sure she's going to say that. And you know, this is a very Southern big word. And not to be braggadocious, but I think I'm a hard worker. I've never seen anyone that works as hard as Demi Clark. You know, throughout her career, she has been the only woman in the room for much of it in the construction and development industry. She's a passionate advocate for equal representation at the table in all things from boardrooms to sports. as the owner, I mean, let's just go down the list of what this woman does. She's the owner of Knight Clark Collective, a boutique consulting firm servicing primarily construction industries. And then, you know, in her off time, she's a triathlete, a mountain climber, and a marathoner. And so last year, after having climbed Mount Kilimanjaro and then summiting mountains in Iceland, she was accepted to Yale's School of Management, Management's Global Executive Leadership Program. And out of that, she said there were going to be no more excuses, that she was going to work to spark the interest of construction and maker trends for women and girls aged 9 to 17. She wants to make sure that women have a future and know that they have a very important place in construction. She's incredible and just is challenging the notions of what our very natures are and who does what in a society. It's my absolute pleasure to introduce you to Demi Clark. And I think she's going to kick her way into your heart like she has mine. Demi, the floor is yours.
Awesome. Wow. Can you hear me? Just checking.
You're good.
Okay. So yeah, kicking down, I'm flipping tables. Like I'm all fired up just to do that. And I've got my Airstream background here. Charlotte Community Tool Bank is hosting me today because that's where we're parking our Airstream. But my first thing, if I was in person, well, first and foremost, can we record that and play that to my teenage daughters? Because I like to believe my own hype every once in a while. And if you have teenagers, you know that you are humbled daily. So they certainly don't believe that I'm that cool. But thank you for that intro. I love it. I would be, if I was in front of you, there's three words people usually describe me throughout my life, and that's energy, inspiration, and hustle, to what you were talking about. So if I was speaking in front of you, which I speak a lot, I would have you stand up. And so if you're sitting, stand up. I'm going to burn about a minute of this talk making you get up, because we've sat down, we've had a lot of inspirational talks and awesome music, but we are not moving. And so I'm a moving person. So if you can, take off the earbuds, get unconnected or disconnected, and stand up. I'm already standing. I'm going to be, because I have these weird virtual backgrounds, I want you to do a V pose. And P.S. I have a hoodie on because it's Generation T, who's a partner of mine. I don't normally wear hoodies like a teenager, further embarrassing my children. So do a V pose. Amy Cuddy, Harvard researcher, if you haven't seen the V pose, this is what you should do before meetings, when you need energy, when you are tired, if you are sitting in your day pajamas instead of your night pajamas. Do a V pose. It's going to re-energize you and take you back into this place of action, which I think is what Tim was hinting at with me. Another word that I try to live my life by is action. I cannot handle inertia. That's COVID life and that's non-COVID life. So if you do anything today going into your Friday, your Zoomapalooza, you're breaking out into the rebirth of Charlotte on May 8th of the safe reopenings, action, supporting the HUG grant, supporting people, supporting creatives, especially, and artists and people who are just rolling up their sleeves every single day to get whatever it is that's in their heart and they're inspired and compelled and convicted to do every day. Go support those people. They don't always need money, but money is fantastic. Now that I run a nonprofit, I certainly value that, but there's other ways you can give of yourself, and Charlotte is beautiful that way. That's why I love Charlotte. So that's my speech for a minute. So hopefully you're re-energized. You can sit back down if you want to. I have two rules. Every time I say spark, just like the woo woo, I'm going to say spark a lot because my tagline is United We Spark for She Built the City. So when we do, if you ever hear me, that's how I know you're listening. If I say the word spark, you're going to do the woot woot for Tim and for Matt. And number two, I always live my life by song lyrics. So I start most of my speeches with them. Right now, I think for this talk, Hamilton is my inspiration on a regular basis. And I say it a lot ever since I went out on my own, took my sabbatical, went to Yale and did the Legally Blonde thing of business, going to Yale, which was very out of my comfort zone, is my shot. So I love the Hamilton mixtape version. Maybe Vaughn, you can be inspired to do a version for us so that we can have that as our sizzle reel for She Built the City as a cover. But I'm not throwing away my shot. That's what I want you to leave this talk with, is you are not throwing away your shot. You're young, scrappy, and hungry, just like your country, and you're not throwing away your shot. And that's how I wake up every single day, is I'm 43 years old. I've been in the construction industry since I was 22. And I still lead teams, and I lead projects, and I hopefully inspire people in the for-profit or nonprofit sides, because I live in both. to not throw away their shot. You shouldn't believe your own hype. You're not that cool. It's not your title. It's what you give and your impact. And again, that's what I love about Charlotte too, is there's so many impactful people and impactful projects. And we're a little town that's in a big town. And so I hope we can preserve that as we keep building each other and building our stories. So I love the build talks. I won't go that cliche though with my talk, because people kind of expect me to be like, oh, she built the city, she builds things. Let's talk about building. You're constructors, like Ohavia said on the last Creative Mornings. I loved that. We are constructors. So construct yourself, construct your outside your box paradigms, construct us and what our new, I'm not going to say new normal, what our new life is going to be like as we reopen and rebirth. And so I think that's how I'll transition into the mother nature. I love the fact that it's Mother's Day weekend. I'm a mom to the moms out there. Woo-hoo. Shout out to you, Spark, Spark, Spark for all our moms. For that, that's what I'm going to talk about today is my, who am I? You heard my spiel, you know, our mission statement for She Built the City. Me, I was the only one woman in the room for 20 plus years. I didn't see enough of me. I wanted more amplification, and I could only, in companies of 7,000 people, they did their best, but there's only so much of me that I could impact to say I could influence 7 to 10 women a year into leadership. So when I took my sabbatical, I went to Yale, and again, yeah, I was like legally blonde. I was a fish out of water, but then I was also challenged to step outside of my comfort zone and what was my nature. I thought, oh, you know, I had a bit of a chip on my shoulder of, well, I was the only woman in the room and I was a little aggressive about it. And then I learned from a lot of people that were in other industries that were a little more equitable that, hey, maybe you should neutralize your position and here's how you can get to impact more people. And then the so what, no, now what? And that's what Mother Nature does, I think, every day when she wakes up in the morning, she says, she throws off the grass, right? She like sleeps in a grass carpet. I'm trying to be cool. She throws off the grass and she says, I'm not throwing away my shot and I'm going to have the most impact and I can do whatever I need to do, no matter what the state of affairs is. And I think that's what we do at She Built the City. That's my personal ethos is so what, now what? We're in XYZ and all of us have something, whether we want to say that it's a pandemic and it's COVID, which is very real, by the way, and I want to validate that, or it's something that's happened in our life. We've had a loss of a job. We've had a loss of a person. We've had a loss of a house. We've had a loss of money. There's something that's hit all of us that you have to get up, dust yourself off, get back in the arena and say, so what, now what? What do I do with this? And so if you don't have all the answers, that's okay. And I didn't at the time. I had no idea how to start a nonprofit. I didn't know what that life was like. Again, I'm a for-profit girl, so I'm earned revenue. I know how to be quarter over quarter life. So I'm a bit of a narwhal or a narwhalicorn, if we want to be, you know, the latest and greatest instead of a unicorn. And my line of work has always gone against the perceived nature of what women are supposed to do. So rather than be a unicorn, I don't want to be a unicorn. I want to see just as many women or however you identify. So that's non-binary, which we don't even talk about in construction yet. That's a very, oof, don't want to go there. You know, how do we understand that whole life? However you identify, we want equal representation in the room. And that's a lot of industries right now and just a lot of life in general. But we're only 9% construction female. And so again, that doesn't even classify non-binary yet. So we don't even know the percentages there, but they're very low. I can tell you that. And only 3% of the traditional trades. So who are we? It's She Built the City. My quick spiel is we have three pillars. We have Explorer Girls, which is 9 to 12-year-old girls, getting them foundational hammer and drill skills, plus future tense skills of what I call 2028 skills, 3D printing. So you see me doing a lot of 3D printing right now. My dream is in Charlotte, we want to build affordable housing that is 3D printed. It can be built in 2 days and it could be solid structures that are affordable. So you heard it here first. I don't know how long it's going to take us. I know there's a lot of us in the town that are working on it, but welcome to the future. And I want to see Charlotte doing it first. And then we have Builder Girls Club, which is the middle schoolers. I work with Generation T and Lowe's on that in terms of only 14% of secondary schools actually have trade and technology education across the country. It's a very low number. And if we expect them to go into the trades, they will not be going into the trades, 14 out of every 100 kids. So we're on a mission to get it back in the middle school. So I'm actively looking for middle schools in the Charlotte-Mecklenburg school system, as well as the 14 County Regional Alliance. So contact me afterwards. And then Women at Work. So we partner with Goodwill Construction Skills Training Center, as well as Lowe's, United Rentals, many, many partners in town, the HBA, NAWIC, sorry for all the name dropping of acronyms, to get out trade circles and shorten that onboard, connecting the dots from the women themselves to the employers. So how have we done the dreaded word pivot? We have done what's behind me, which is an Airstream. Rather than just cancel our camps, cancel any of our programming, we had just hit our stride in February. And I remember having a bottle of wine when COVID hit and saying, why me? But, and then I said, wait, there's a lot of people that are way worse off than me right now in terms of overhead, in terms of personnel, paycheck protection. We were very young. So I said, so what, now what? So you go to sleep with your problem and you wake up with your solution, right? So the wine was my you know, quick answer. And then waking up in the morning, I rolled up my sleeves and I said, what are we gonna do? We're gonna adapt. And so that's what Mother Nature would do. She would adapt. She adapts every single day. And so I adapted and we got an Airstream and we're upfitting it and we're gonna make it our mobile tool lab. And now that gives us the mobility come the summer, hopefully June, to come into at-risk neighborhoods, to go to employers and do training in our learning zone, which will have a 3D printer and online seats where women can train on forklift and then walk right into the employer and get the job. We can take it to girls and put drills in their hands, socially distanced at community center parking lots. So I'll look to this community once we're ready with this Airstream to take it out around Charlotte and be a big fat mobile billboard of getting into the trades and inspiring this next generation to hustle and work hard. Because who's working right now? Let's face it. It's the trades. It's our essential workplace. And hopefully that destigmatizes our trades a little bit. So it's helpful, but that's our pivot, and also virtual shop class. So we took everything online like everyone else, but we're trying to bring to parents and to kids through Generation T virtual shop class and bring that inspiration of using your hands to build something in a workshop and getting off the computer. So we don't do it via Zoom, but Zoom has its place. So what I want to leave you with, rather than a whole bunch of talking about She Built the City, is, you know, what are five ways that I've been like Mother Nature, not only going against my nature, but it also leads us into that breakout rooms. What are five ways that Mother Nature is just crushing it every day that we can take into our own lives? Okay, first, she's the OG underdog. She's constantly fighting against the perils out there and being that V pose herself, an Avenger, and saying, you know what? We have pollution. We have humans that are doing all kinds of things to me. And no matter what, I am going to be the number one at some point, and I'm going to win. And so she's always fighting for the next step. And I think that's women in business. That's definitely women in construction due to the percentages I was talking about earlier. And I had huge PSA here. I had phenomenal bosses that were men, as well as phenomenal mentors. One that I just talked to for two hours yesterday. So I want to give a lot of credence to the men who helped me get to where I am. So now that turns into allyship. So men on here who want to support women in gender inequitable industries, be an ally. That's where you start, because I get a lot of men asking me that question. But back to Mother Nature, she's fearless. Spark, 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 spark. Right? She is fearless. She doesn't worry about what is coming her way. There's no weather report. She's a hustler. She's a hustling adapter. So, you know, to the pivot point, she is a hustler. So we all have to get up and hustle every day. I hustle every day. I'm going to be hoofing it in this trailer, this Airstream today. I'm not so cool that I can't pick up a tool, wear a hoodie, get super dirty, and make action happen. So that's what it's going to take. I can't hire somebody to go do that. That's on me, because I promised that I was going to deliver an Airstream. That's the ROI, right? And that's what Mother Nature does. That's what we need to do, is take that action that Tim was talking about. She blooms where she's planted. I think all of us are in a place now of stagnation, right? We're all in our homes, or we may or may not be at a voluntary level of going back into a work in some situation in a place next week, thanks to the lifting of some of the orders, but it's still stagnant, right? So rather than saying, okay, I'm gonna wait and see, Mother Nature doesn't do that. She has to have the roses come through the concrete, right? Every morning, something is there where she's blooming where she was planted. So I give you that challenge of bloom where you're planted this weekend. What are you going to do? How are you going to act? If that is financially, if that is with your hands, if that is physical activity, if that's being present for your family, spiritually, emotionally, whatever that is, bloom where you're planted. And then finally, and my favorite, is that she lives in full diverse color. Look around us, it's spring. That should give us hope. the one thing that pushes everyone to inspiration in the world, no matter what we're doing or what jobs we fill in the world. She lives in full color. And that is the beauty of Charlotte, is that we live in full color. We have a diverse mix of amazing human beings. And we need to preserve that as we reopen our lives out of this COVID life, is to say, how diverse can we stay? How inclusive can we be? And also, how can we keep that color of really inspiring people to move forward? Which, another PSA on how you can help us, is we want a big, bright, beautiful mural on this lovely Airstream, which is a blank canvas. So my challenge to the muralists that we definitely want to pay for your work is that we want something really big and bold on that to give people smiles, color, and inspiration. So that's it. What's my action item from you, for you from this talk, is back to Hamilton. Don't throw away your shot. Don't throw away your shot. You're young, scrappy, and hungry, just like your country and just like your beautiful Queen City. And how are you going to take that shot into this weekend? It's the Friday. It's your Zoomapalooza. What are you going to do as we break out of our shells and move into the next era of this summer? And how can we act and not stay stagnant? So I think that's what brings me. Well, how can you help us this Airstream? I am stock in the stream this month. So I'm looking for trade partners. We're also looking for financial donations so that we can get gas cards and get it around. And then also partnerships. We would love to come to your communities. We would love to bring the beauty of the trades and the solutions that the trades can provide into our lives right now, to girls, boys, however gender classifications and identifications are, and women into jobs. So we want to get people hired in the Queen City and get those 100,000 trade jobs we need filled by 2028, COVID notwithstanding, taken care of, and people earning super family wages. So that gets to our question. So Tim, you want me to pitch it on the question?
Let's do it. Hit it.
Okay, so I challenge you, first and foremost, take as many V pose breaks as you possibly want. But at the same time, going into this breakout room, what is one way that you can go against the stagnant nature of life right now that we're somewhat forced and really voluntarily living? So I want to give that credence, that we're following the rules. But how can you take action, whether that's personal, professional, spiritual, emotional? How can you act? What is the one way you're going to ignite your spark going into this weekend, and tell your breakout room, how are you going to do that? And how are you going to do that for somebody else? And thanks for listening.
Awesome. God, I think you guys can see why Demi was the perfect speaker for today. I mean, just every conversation's got me ready to run through a brick wall. And listen, I love Demi. I got to tell you, you mentioned the Avengers. I love Brie Larson, but I'm going to start a petition that you take over the role of Captain Marvel moving forward. I think you better represent that Avengers spirit. I also spent some time while you're talking trying to get the rights to narwhalacorn.com. It's already been taken. I'm very sorry.
And thank you again, Demi Clark, for gifting us with your perspective on nature this morning and your energy. Just like our two Who Built Me speakers, Sarah and Henry, you are also going to get your very own Camp North End package. Thanks again to our friends at Camp North End for supporting our HUG grant program in that really cool way. All right, before we end with our final announcements and creative challenge, a lot of us do have all these thoughts and feelings about nature swirling around our hearts and our minds right now. And so I can't think of a better time than right now to throw the spotlight over to Angelo Iambic Jeter so he can hit us with his own poetic take on the theme. Angelo is an accomplished spoken word artist. He's a motivational speaker. He's performed all over the country. 2019 All-America City winner, National Poetry Slam champion, regional poetry finalist, and he currently serves as the Poet Laureate of Rock Hill, South Carolina. If you are so moved, please do send him some love in the form of some Venmo tips. Daybreak Legends, to close us out here before our final words, I give you Angelo Iambic Jeter.
Morning. So there's a famous phrase that says, the glass is half empty or half full, depending on your perspective. Your vantage point determines on what you see inside. But you know, they never tell you what's exactly inside of the cup. The focus is on the container and not on the contents. The shell is demoted to nothing more than a carrier for loose metaphor. When the reality is, it doesn't matter how much exists inside if one sip will kill you. The glass is only as good as what you pour into it. You know, poison is poison, pollution is pollution. The measure of the liquid will only decide how soon your heartbeat would be crescendoed into a flat line. So, if Earth is the glass, we must be cautious servers, filling her with ounces of love and overflowing with compassion. If Earth is the glass, then we cannot break her, because we also be breaking ourselves. If we abuse her, we are also abusing ourselves, and isn't that human nature? To destroy things we don't understand, to use comprehension as a weapon, to use a fist to punch through a wall instead of using our minds to break through glass ceilings. You know, in this pandemic, I have learned that it doesn't matter how much is actually in your cup. What matters is what you use to fill it. And as long as it's a cocktail of humanity and faith and love and belief, you will never be thirsty again. Thank you.
Wow, man, thank you so much. Angelo, you're incredible. Please do send him some tip love on Venmo or Cash App. That was an amazing way to close us out here. Tim, give everyone the creative challenge for the month.
All right. So like Demi said, we got to get out there. We're breaking out. The governor says we can do it. So last month, we asked you to take a challenge and really look around and find a new creative every day to champion. But this time, we're going to do a little differently. We want you to thank the creatives, right? Thank the people that make life in Charlotte majestic, inside and out. Thank them personally, thank them online, and thank them with cash if you can, because creativity is not free. You must invest in the things that you love. And if you go to our stories on CM_CLT, you can take a screenshot of a page that allows you to go and share creatives that you love in Charlotte with everyone that follows you. Please take that time and just say thank you in every way you can. And we'll see you next month.
Thank you, Tim. And there you have it, folks. Zoomapalooza 2 Domestic Boogaloo is officially in the books.
Boom.
We'll be sending you an email in the next day or so with links to everything you saw and the people you learned about this morning. And we'll be announcing soon when our June gathering will be. So stay tuned for that. And finally, I want to say thank you to our CM Creative Mornings volunteer team. And thank you to you for being with us this morning. Until we meet again next month, stay strong, stay safe. I know we joked a little bit about getting out, but the truth is wearing masks, washing your hands, maintaining social distancing is the best way to keep yourself and others healthy while we await a vaccine. But of course you will, right? It's in your nature. You're smart, you're courteous, you're responsible. And you're the most attractive Creative Mornings family on the planet. We'll see you online, out in the world, and back here at Creative Mornings next month. Have a great weekend, everybody. We love you.
Thank you.
Love you all. Have a good one.